capacity crowd on hand in Chesapeake, Virginia, as this city once again plays host to one of the most prestigious events in the sport of pocket billiards. These are the United States Open 9-Ball Championships. Today, out of the loser's bracket, a semifinal match between Buddy Hall and Jose Parica. Remember, this is a double elimination tournament, so these two will play for the right to play Johnny Archer. Archer was a loser to Tom Kennedy, who has already won his way into the final. So Archer awaits the winner of this match between Hall and Parica. The winner of this plays Archer for the right to play Kennedy for the U.S. Open Championship. And hello again, everybody. I'm Barry Tompkins, along with the three-time U.S. Open champion, Mike Sigel. And Mike, you know, they talk about parity in the NFL. I don't think that's anything compared to the parity that we're seeing these days in pocket billiards. Every week, it seems to be somebody else.
That's very true. And this week, we have two players that we've seen many, many times on ESPN. And we also have two players that we haven't seen. So that's going to call for an interesting contest.
Tom Kennedy is already in the final, but let's talk about the match that we're going to be seeing today. Buddy Hall, first of all, a guy who's been around the track more than once.
Yeah, I have a lot of experience with Buddy. He's been around many, many times. As you know, he has tremendous cue ball control. I think that's one of his biggest assets. He's very methodical the way he plays the game, and I know, and everybody else knows, that he definitely can find a way to win a match, so he's going to be very dangerous.
Let's talk about Jose Parica for a minute. He's a guy who has had some experience and won a lot of tournaments.
He really has. He's from the Philippines. He's been around our tour for many, many years. He kind of comes in on a visa off and on. I think it's probably his biggest asset. He has tremendous heart. I played him numerous times in close matches. He plays very good under pressure, and he's very knowledgeable. He understands the game, so, you know, Buddy's going to have his hands filled. And on top of that, earlier in the tournament, I believe Parica did beat Buddy on the winner's side, so this may be a more of a grudge match than anything else.
This is a double elimination tournament. Each man has now lost once, so for today, it's one and done. Let's take a look at the rules. It's a race to nine. The balls, of course, are shot in numerical order. The winner will break. A scratch or a foul means cue ball in hand to the other player. All the balls that go down stay down. The push rule is in effect. We'll speak a little bit more of that. And something that can be a factor in this match, there is a 40-second shot clock. And with that, we are set for the lag for the break. Very appreciative crowd here in Chesapeake, and a knowledgeable crowd. And Parica got the better of it. So he will break to start things here.
Well, it looks like Buddy is already, he's kind of concerned about the break. You know, normally what happens is, a lot of times in nine-ball matches, not only playing a race of nine, in the beginning, the first two or three games could set the pace of what's to come. So Buddy's a little concerned about even losing a lag at this case.
You made an interesting point. We were talking just before they started here, too, that this is a brand new table to both players.
Exactly right. This is one of the tables that was used outside, and players are doing trick shots and whatever on it. And it really wasn't used in the tournament, so the cloth is fairly new. The table is going to play a little different than the tables we had been using in the tournament for the last week. So that is going to come into play as far as how each player can adapt to the table the quickest. Again, that's going back to the break. The guy that gets the rhythm first maybe is going to have a big advantage.
So we are finally set to go.
Look at Jose. He's funny. The little man, but I'll tell you what, he's big when it comes to pool. Hit the balls good.
Got something down, so he will stay out there. Here's how Jose Parica got as far as this. His one loss came to the man who we mentioned earlier, who's already in the final, Tom Kennedy. Kennedy undefeated so far in this tournament. He's been a pro for, what, 3 months?
Yeah, exactly. See, Jose played a great shot. He positioned the cue ball in this area for the three, which is up in this area. He made a great shot on the two, and you can see the four is right in this area. He made another good pitch. And I think he drew that ball a little bit more than he would like. He's got a little bit more angle on the four than he would like. See, he's a little concerned about the cue ball sliding way over to our left, so he's got to hit the shot pretty soft or hit it very hard to go across the table. He elected to hit it soft and hit very good.
Table seems pretty wide open for him right now.
He's in a good spot. You see the five, the orange ball. And see, he's positioning the Q-tip where he would like the cue ball. The six is on the bottom rail. His problem is going to be going from the six to the seven if he pockets the five. He doesn't want to get straight on the six. Whoops, see, he's got a little bit of an angle. Now, he could draw or follow the cue ball. You see the seven is way up table. Then he has to actually come back for the nine, so he wants to make sure he gets at least halfway up table to play a shot on the seven. As you see, elected to draw the cue ball. Perfect.
So very good opening rack for Jose Parica, barring the unforeseen. He will draw first blood in this match. Race to nine, remember.
He hit that shot a little softer than he would like, but he's shaking his head. He doesn't like it. On the opening rack, he'd rather be straighter on the nine, but I believe he should get a good result here.
There you have it, just like that. Absolutely no problem on the first rack for Jose Parica. He leads Buddy Hall 1-0. We'll be back.
All that Chesapeake offers, such as recreation, specialty shops, and fine restaurants. Located next to Norfolk and Virginia Beach, Chesapeake is close to ocean beaches and cultural attractions. And Chesapeake is just a short drive from Colonial Williamsburg and North Carolina's Outer Banks. If you're planning a visit to southeastern Virginia, be sure to include Chesapeake in your travel plan.
Welcome back to the Pro Billiards Tour. I'm Barry Tompkins along with Mike Sigel. This is the U.S. Open Championship, the semifinal match. You're looking at Jose Parica. Ran the first rack. Leads Buddy Hall 1-0. Buddy Hall, you have to get off the chair.
Ooh. He'll two balls off on the break. Look where the one ball wound up. The cue ball is right next to the one. You see, he was rolling down. Now, obviously, you can see the one landed right in this area right here, and the cue ball's right next to it, so obviously he's got a good shot at the one. The two is near the pocket. This may set him up for another game. Again, we were talking about earlier, see, now Buddy Hall hasn't shot yet. Realistically, there's a possibility that Parica could run nine racks. It's been done, so, I mean, that's why there's a lot of pressure in pool. The average person doesn't realize that you may never shoot again.
What are we going to do for the last half hour of the show if that happens? How's your tap dancing?
Well, it's possible. He made a nice shot there. You notice he drew the cue ball two rails. Even though he bumped the three, he hit the two a little thicker, or actually fuller than he would like. That's why the cue ball bumped the three, but obviously it turned out all right. Now he's going to play the three in the red ball. I really can't see the angle. He may have to go up the table and down again. That's exactly what he's doing. I see what he's looking at. The nine ball, possibly. I don't know. That shot looks like he can play the four in the lower right-hand portion of the screen. And he's also going to look to billiard the nine to our left. Now let's see what happens.
Well, yes, there it is, just like that. Nice call. You played this game before.
Yeah, I played a few times, yeah. That was a very, very smart play by Jose.
Let's take another look at the replay on this shot. As you can see, the four and nine, you see he plays the four, and the nine floats right into the pocket. Let's take another look at this.
Well, maybe we won't take another
look. Okay, we won't. We saw it
enough. But imagine it.
It was a very good shot. And again, going down to the opening leg of the break, you could see that Buddy Hall was very concerned when he lost a leg. Everybody else here sitting around fingers, well, you know, what could happen? And here we have a 2-0 lead and still going.
And there's Buddy Hall in this one of those sports that there's nothing you can do about it except sit there.
Yeah, I really feel there's more pressure in pool than any other sport for this particular reason. In golf, bowling, any sport like that, at least you have your opportunities. Where in pool,
here's another look.
You don't. Okay, we are going to have another look at this. Now here's a shot. Watch the four going the upper portion of the screen and the cue ball billiards right into the nine. Both balls. It looked like a trick shot.
Of course, it did, really. The game is nine ball, remember, and as long as you hit the object ball, what happens after that counts.
Now, Parica got good results from this side of the table. He's staying there. Watch. Notice the corner ball and the one went in the side, and look at this. Another clear shot at the two ball. The two ball is in the lower portion of your screen. Okay, you notice the two ball's right in this area. He's got a pretty clear shot at the two. It's a shot that is not a difficult shot, but the three ball is in this area right here. That's going to be his problem. He's got to get position on the three. It's not easy.
And now he could have a little bit of a problem.
Well, again, he was straight on the two ball, and what happened was, you can see he was straight on the two ball. Now, his problem is right here. He actually didn't get the cue ball in a position. He should have been more in this area. It was a very tough position. Now he's got to try and kick, hit the rail, and hopefully either make the three or play safe. Looks like he's playing rail first.
Oh, and he scratched.
That was a big break for Buddy right there. Again, going back to the two ball, even though the shot was easy, the position was very, very difficult. So now, Buddy, this is pretty nice to start with your opening shot with cue ball in hand. Of course, Buddy, I think, would rather be out fishing right now. That's that's his love and mine also. He'll be doing that, I'm sure, after this tournament.
So Buddy Hall knocks it in. Here's how he got to this semifinal match. His only loss, interestingly enough, was to Jose Parica, the man who he's playing. Close match. Everything else he won, and won relatively handily, except for the match with LeBron.
Okay, now Buddy didn't come down on the five. He's got a tough shot here. He didn't get far enough. He's going to try and, I believe, cut the five in the side, but this is no easy shot.
Nice touch.
Yeah, that shot looked a little easier on the camera. We're sitting up here looking. That was a nice shot. He came around perfect for the seven. He'll play the seven aside. Probably draw back for the eight in the same pocket. There's really no mystery about when Buddy runs out. It's pretty much, you know, what you see is what you get. He runs the balls probably as good as anybody I've ever seen. Look at the position on the nine compared to, let's say, Jose's Parica shot on the nine.
And he's a guy I would think if you're playing him, you don't want to give him momentum.
No. His cue ball control.
Jose Parica opened the door and Buddy Hall runs through it. 2-1.
Since we opened our door.
Chesapeake, Virginia, Jose Parica, 1-4, earning a 3-1 lead. Then broke and ran out in rack 5, stretching his lead to 4-1. In rack 6, Buddy Hall took advantage of a ball-in-hand situation and won the rack with this combination. So now we pick up the action with Jose Parica leading Buddy Hall 4-2.
You know, that's really hard to believe. Buddy Hall broke and didn't make the one on the side or the corner ball. He really can't believe it. And he's walking back, but now Jose Parica can obviously hit the one, the yellow ball, lowest number ball on the table, but there is no shot. He's going to have to play some kind of a safe. As you can see, the one and the cue ball and the five are actually almost froze right in this area. So Jose is going to look to actually hit the edge of the one and possibly either put the cue ball up table or something of this nature to put Buddy in a tough situation. And look what he did there. That was pretty good.
Yeah, not bad.
Well, I'll tell you what. Actually, he made a bad shot there because Buddy can hit. He's smiling again, Buddy. Buddy can hit the lower portion of the one ball. And the cue ball, you can see he can hit the... As we're looking at the... You can see he hit the right edge of the one ball and hopefully send the cue ball in a position where he's stuck. And that's exactly what he did. Great shot. I mean... Because people don't realize how tough that is. The speed of the cue ball went right around the two. If he hits the two ball, the lower ball on the end rail, Parica would have had a shot at the one, but he went right around that ball and forced Parica now to go to a rail. So that was a great shot. That's as much of winning or losing a game as it is. Just like in the last game, we saw how Buddy made a strategic shot you can see the cue balls in this area behind these balls, the 4 and 9. The 1 is in this area. So Parica, it looks like he's going to have to come here, but the 7 is kind of in the way, so this is not automatic.
That is a tough shot.
He just hit it. Oh, but he scratched. Look.
That's a shame.
Hey, look at this. Wait a minute. I'm seeing something a little bit ahead. He's got the 1. Parica, Parica got a little bad roll there. He hit the 1. Let's take another look at it. Now, what he does is he hits the cue ball up table, comes down, just grazes the 1, and kisses the 5 and scratches. That's a little unlucky.
And I think I see what you're looking at, though. You're looking ahead at the 2 ball.
Yeah, the 2-9, you see. My buddy's got a nice shot on the 1. And you can see the 2 ball is on the lower portion of the screen, lined up with the 9 ball. So that's what he's going for. Another easy shot. You can see the 2 and 9 are right about in this area right here.
And he's sitting pretty.
And hopefully he can play it in this corner pocket.
This well, for 3-4.
That's a good look at it.
There it is.
Great. Look how fast, huh?
Amazing. 2 cheapies. And he'll take them all. And he's had no luck on the break either.
Okay, let's look at the replay here. You see the 2 going right into the 9. Great shot.
So Buddy Hall now has moved within 1 game in his race to 9. We'll be back. Rika, by only 1 game now, 4-3 in his race to 9.
You know, the funny thing is when the referee, see, normally we play rack our own balls. For the televised matches, we have a referee rack them. And if the balls are even slightly apart or any little thing on the rack, the outcome of the rack can be devastating. So this is why, see, Buddy, again, he made a ball that time, but he didn't make the corner ball.
And the 1 ball, he's got a problem.
Yeah.
I think.
Well,
we don't have a very good angle at it from where we sit, incidentally, I should point out.
Well, actually, you can see the group right up here, the 1 ball, the yellow ball's in the middle, the cue ball's down table. Now, to be honest with you, from right here, and actually the way Buddy's looking at it, I think there's a possibility he could actually make this. I'm not too sure. The 2 ball is down to the lower portion of the table, lower left portion, so the 2 is in a good position if he happens to make the 1, but he's shooting at it, so obviously there is room in there, very tight. Oh, boy, he hit that good. Wow. And look at this. He hit that shot extremely good. But the pockets are a little smaller than what we were used to playing. You can see he shoots the 1. Watch this. He hit it unbelievable. I can't believe the ball didn't go in. And now Jose Parica has the gap right in between the 2 balls. You can see the cue ball, he's got the gap in between the 5 and 7 to shoot directly at the 1.
Just like that, huh?
Now, wait a minute. What did he do here? Look at this. Well, he looks like he's shooting, but I'll tell you what, he got a little lucky there, I think, because the 9, the yellow striped ball, looks like it's just about in the way, but obviously, boy, another inch or two up to the right, he wouldn't have had an easy shot. All right, well, he's got a nice shot on the 3, the red ball. He's a little straighter, I believe, than he would like. You can see when he plays the 2, he's hitting with a high right English. Cue ball comes off the rail. Had just enough room to get by the 9. Okay, here he wants to play the 4. Here he's going to play the 4 ball, which is right here. His problem is the 6 ball. He's going to have to come either draw the cue ball way up table. The 7's blocking 1 pocket up there. So he wants to see, he came up a little short. This is a very tough shot. You can see he really wanted the cue ball in this area to play the 6 up in here. Now he's going to have to cut the 6 in that pocket, and it's not an easy shot.
Especially, as you said, little smaller pockets here. And
see
there
what
it
happens.
Is.
There you go. Now, you know what the perfect example of that is? Buddy Hall would have never been in that position. You follow me? So, therefore, when Buddy gets an opportunity, look at Buddy's flying around the table. He can't believe it. That's one thing about Buddy's game. When he does get an opportunity normally to run out. Now, you see the shot. I explained it. The angle is very difficult. He hits the ball too full, just hits the point, misses the shot, and gives Buddy an open rack here.
Cuts that in nicely. I tell you, you saw Buddy Hall jump up and stand next to Parica. Parica looked like an hors d'oeuvre next to him.
You can see how one shot actually can turn the whole match around. And when a top player misses with, let's say, 3, 4, 5 balls left on the table, it gives the other player, you know, tremendous momentum and confidence. Let's see what Buddy did here. He's got a shot at the 8. You can see he's got a shot at the 8 ball, but coming back down, let's say this way, for the 9 or drawing straight down the table is going to be a little difficult. Okay, hit that shot nice. I thought it was difficult, except for anybody but Buddy. You can see the speed was absolutely flawless. Now he's on the rail, but it's a shot that he figures to make.
And if he does make it, we will be tied at 4-all. And there it is, Buddy Hall, starting to gain a little bit of momentum in this semifinal match, much to the applause of the good folks here in Chesapeake. We'll be back.
Hi, I'm Mike Massey. I call this the ultimate trap shot. I've got to hit the one ball and make the nine.
You guys are. I hate that. Make a really difficult game seem very easy, and that's exactly what Buddy Hall has been doing here over the last two games, as he has made a pretty good comeback here. He's down 4-1, remember.
Yeah, how quickly it changes. Now Buddy's breaking from this spot. Let's see if the right corner ball goes in. Ah, you see it went in that time. He made the corner ball. He's squeezing for a shot. He's got a shot. This is going to be very tough. Okay, obviously he made the corner ball, which the ball has been going in this particular pocket. Now his problem is going to be the one is here, the 2-9 in this area. Very difficult to get position. He's got to actually draw or foul the cue ball to come all the way down table. There's balls in the way. The shot on the one is decent, but getting position is very tough. We're going to have to see what he does. He's probably going to draw the cue ball, hopefully missing the seven, coming back and coming down for the two ball. Great shot. Look at this shot. Oh. Well, you got, look at this. That's perfect. The kind of shot, absolutely perfect. He took a little chance. He missed the seven was the key thing, plus making the one. He grazed the three. I believe that that he deserved to get anything he got there because that was a phenomenal shot.
That was a big-time shot, a big-time player.
Well, I mean, it's 4-4, you know, and they're only playing now a race to five, so obviously that's why this guy has been there many, many times. You know, Buddy Hall is 47 years old. And look how good he's still playing pool. That gives all us other players, we kind of enjoy that because I know I have many years to go myself. That was a pretty nice shot. He kind of just rolled the ball in. Okay, now he's looking at the five to see if it goes by. You can see the four ball, the purple ball is at the lower portion. The lower right-hand portion of your screen. Now, the five, the orange ball, I don't know if it goes by the nine or he wants to play a 5-9 combination. We see, obviously, the five couldn't go by the six into this corner pocket, so I think the five must go. As you can see, the five was very tough to go in this pocket. The five has a chance of going in here. I think he's going to shoot that over the combination. Yeah.
All right.
And he made that on the upper portion of the pocket, so that was a tough shot. Well, let's look at the replay of that shot. Now, what? Look how much room there is. He just cleared the nine ball. Very tough shot. He's going to play the six, draw the cue ball up table. He's absolutely perfect. All he's going to do now is play the seven, draw the cue ball towards the nine ball, a little bit to the right of how we see it. Now, they're not playing foul on all balls here. Some tournaments we do that. They're not doing that here. As you can see, he drew the cue ball down. He's got a relatively nice shot up nine. In some of our other tournaments, a lot of times if you touch a ball, it's actually a foul, but here they don't play that rule. Very rarely if somebody hit a nine ball anyway.
There it is. And that for 5-4, and Buddy Hall has now won four in a row and leads for the first time in this semifinal match. The winner of this plays Johnny Archer.
Wham, right, yep. In. Actually got kissed in, but it was heading that way anyway. And let's see what happens here.
Oh, he's got the one down, didn't he?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. He didn't want the one to go in. You can see the one ball, the yellow ball, is right in front of the side pocket. You hardly can't miss it. But his problem is going to be actually the two and three in the lower portion of your table, lower left-hand portion. You can see the two balls are now. You can see the one, the yellow ball, is in this area. Easy shot, but the two and three over here actually blocked by Buddy's arm. That's going to be a little tricky because it doesn't look like anything can go in easy there, even though the balls are near the hole. He may have to play the two and hit it into the rail, bounce off. This is a little tricky. This is very, very tricky.
What actually. Do you do here, Mike?
Well, you know, actually, the tube ball doesn't have room to get by. So what I think he'll do is hit it like this, hit the tube, bank it off, and play the three actually rail first. I believe that's what I would do here. That's exactly what he did, and hit it perfect. Look at that shot. Boy, he hit that so good. You know, that's a shot that can be missed so easy. Let's take another look at this. He hits the two straight as it lays. The cue ball comes off the rail, just nips the three in, and absolutely perfect, the two. He didn't, if he hit it too hard, the two would have gone too far away. But now he has more problems. He can play the two, but the four ball is way up table. He's got to draw the cue ball and make sure he goes high enough not to snooker himself. See what happened there. He played the two. He hit it, the shot good, but he didn't come far enough for the four ball, which the four ball is right up here, but the seven, the maroon ball, which is right in this area, is actually in front of the four. He can hit the four, but he can't make it. I believe he's going to elect to play a safe, cut the four to the side rail, and put the four maybe in the middle of the end rail and let the cue ball go down table. That was the correct shot. That was the correct shot. He let Parica hit it. As you can see, put the four ball in a great spot, the cue ball. He would probably prefer to have the cue ball behind the nine like this, but Parica can hit the four, but it's a very tough shot. He either can bank the ball possibly to the left, lower left-hand corner pocket right where he's standing, or he could play a safe. This is where
33 inches.
33, and I had guessed right around.
As you can see, he's hitting the cue ball into the rail. Just hits the two. When those shots go in, they look so easy. When you miss them, you look so foolish.
Yes. That was a tough chance that he took there. He needs to stay at the table. All he needs to do is run this rack out.
He made a nice shot on the three. Forced it. He got perfect position on the three, too. As you can see, he played the three. He's got the four ball right here. Now he's going to play the four in the side pocket. He's just going to slide the cue ball. Hit it very soft. Wow. Okay, now he's got... You know, I think his nerves are a little bit on end. He's got the five ball. This is not an easy shot. He's got to play the five, bounce off the rail a little bit for the seven, which is the right-hand top portion. He made it so easy. You know, these shots, he's shooting these shots. They make them look so easy, but those are tough, tough shots under the circumstances, especially playing somebody like Buddy Holt.
Yeah, he's looking pretty confident right now is Parica.
Okay, now what he elected to do there was actually hold the cue ball. I probably might have forced the cue ball to come around the table. Again, he's got to actually hit the cue ball very low and soft. Cut the eight in. Hit it very nice. The cue ball's going a little further than he would like.
But I'm sure he'll take it.
He likes it. He likes it.
And this for the match.
Wow.
And there it is.
What a match.
Jose Parica has moved through to the semifinal. He will play Johnny Archer. The winner of that match plays for the whole banana.
That was some match there. Well, I would like to see what happened if Buddy didn't get corner hooked on that particular ball on the seven ball.
That's a terrific win for Jose Parica, and what he did for the most part was keep Buddy Hall frozen on his seat.
Yeah, he really played a great match.
Now that quickly made the big shots and had a little bit of luck too. That's what it takes. We'll be back. And we welcome you back to Chesapeake, Virginia. This, of course, the U.S. Open nine-ball semifinal, which is now history. Jose Parica is the winner over Buddy Hall, 9-5. It was a brilliantly played match for Parica. He now will move on to play Johnny Archer. At the moment, the winner of this semifinal is with our own Kevin Cusick. Kev?
Okay, Barry, thank you very much. Jose, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you. My opportunity being... played Buddy Hall in a semifinal and beat him is kind of a big, big victory for me.
Very big victory. Buddy Hall has done awfully well. He just won the Challenge of Champions. He's been playing great the last 2-3 years on the tour. You said you've played him the last 6 years on and off, and you pretty much don't have trouble with Buddy Hall, as was the case again today.
Yeah, every time I play Buddy, I get the roll, and then it all seems that I play good against him, more open. Well, the last year, that's his year, you know, and he beats me 3 in a row last year.
Well, he beat you 3 in a row last year. This year, you'll have to contend next with Johnny Archer. He's the number one ranked player on the tour. Talk about what you'll need to do to beat him. If you play like you played today against Buddy Hall, you certainly might have a good shot.
Yeah, definitely. You can't tell whoever wins, you know, because we're just almost the same level. I mean, if you miss, you know, you give me a turning point, maybe the nature of the game changes.
Okay, well, Jose Parica, once again, congratulations to you. Good luck against Johnny Archer. And Barry, back to you.
All right, thanks very much, Kevin. Well, it doesn't get any easier for Jose Parica. It's out of the frying pan and into the fire. He beats Buddy Hall for the second time in this event, but now he gets Johnny Archer, another experienced player and another very, very good player on the pro billiard circuit. So it'll be Archer and Parica in our next match. You heard Parica say that he had to get the opportunistic shots. This was the shot that perhaps did it more than any other. For us, that's a wrap. For Kevin Cusick and Mike Sigel, I'm Barry Tompkins. We'll see you next time.